Good evening to all of you. You're watching Lok Sabha TV. I'm Anurag Puneta with you. In a bid to revive public sector banks' image, Finance Minister Nirmala Sitaraman asked banks to be more savvy and smart to woo more customers and also dedicate at branch level and personally connect with the customers to provide better services. She underlined the need for public sector banks to leverage their local language advantage they have over the private banks. She reminded banks that the people have been voicing concern that the staffs at bank branches are not friendly and unable to speak local and regional languages. She emphasized that at least one member at a bank's branch should speak the regional language, adding banks should work at branch level in better and spirit of the banking, which is direct connect with the customers. Now, public sector banks will provide services like dial a loan, credit at a click, and a palm banking for end-to-end delivery of financial services. She though said that the lenders, that means the banks, should be responsive in lending and inform customers why they can't disburse loans to them if they are not eligible. But this, she said, should not be misconstrued that the banks should compromise on the use of technology. Public sector banks will focus on now smart lending and the push use for of technology for facilities like doorstep facilitation of retail and MSME loans. According to the reports that have come recently, that the public sector banks have returned to the profitability with a sound financial health. The report said that the lenders have been able to recover approximately more than 2 lakh crore in the first 9 months of the current financial year. So we are going to find out that how these steps should be construed and should be seen in better banking, and what are the challenges in front of the public sector banks in this edition of Public Forum. And joining me for the discussion in the studio, Mr. Ashwini Rana, banking expert, and one more guest, Professor Aman Agarwal, will join me soon through Skype. We'll talk to him as well. Professor Aman Agarwal is a director and professor of the Indian Institute of Finance. But I would begin with you, Ashwini ji. How do you see that? Kaise dekha jaye? I mean, if we can say that somehow she is concerned that the bank's image should improve. Aap kaise dekhte?
Definitely, there is no doubt. Is concern regarding public sector bank image is genuine. His concern is genuine, no doubt. But we have to see that whatever we expect from such public sector bank, and we are comparing from private sector, we have to see the difference of the working and their culture. See, private banks, they are hiring local people. They are liberty to hire the people, whereas the public sector bank, they have to national prospect, they have to hire.
Okay.
And people from north, they are posting to south. How you can see that he will be more convenient with the local language?
Okay.
For that, you have to go for regional recruitment. That will be good for the persons also. Means staff also, they will be posted at local places, local level. This is one thing. Second, there should not be any pressure from any agency that you give such loans.
Okay.
Banks are giving.
Banks are giving loans to the people.
People.
Okay.
Time to time, they are conducting the melas, loan melas. They are giving the scheme. They are going to the public. But banks have some restrictions, means they have less staff.
Okay.
They have government schemes also. They have to implement the government schemes also. They have to give the loans also. For that, they are not having the much trained and sufficient staff. Workforce.
But this is the impression normally that the public sector banks or the government banks, we call them conveniently, that whenever they go for such drive, I mean, what you call the loan mela, or disbursing the loans to the public, there is a sense of lethargy. There is a sense of, they are doing it just for the heck of it. Somehow, either they don't have the proper staff, or they are overburdened with the work, or there are some maybe some other reasons. But somehow, the sense goes to the public ki wo khali kaam niptane ke liye kar rahe hain.
Nahi, aisa nahi hai. There is not. It is there. They are doing whatever the capacity, whatever the staff strength, whatever the resources they are having, means their staff strength also depends. Na?
Okay.
And their funds based and requirement of the people. People expectation is more.
Okay.
But you have to fulfill the conditions of the bank also. Na? See, public sector bank and private sector bank lendings are different. They are very harsh by giving the lending. They are through agents, they are giving the lending. Whereas public sector bank, directly they are dealing with the customers. Public sector bank don't have any agents between the customer and banks. So, the system of the lending between this public sector and private sector, it is a different. And work culture also will be different.
Work culture ko kaise aap badlenge? Matlab mera sawal ye hai ki badlenge kaise aap us culture ko? Kyunki maan lijiye agar wo agent hire karte hain, to who is stopping them? I mean the public sector banks to hire the agent. Kya ye theek rahega in long run or nahi rahega?
No, no, it is not good. Because agent, abhi kabhi you will see in private banks, agents, there is so many frauds for this retail lendings.
Okay, yeah.
But
yeah.
Public sector bank, they will see the do and root, everything they will verify, then they will give. But for that, banks have to hire more people, more educated people. Now, most of the seniors have been retired. Now, whatever people are coming, they are not much experienced. Means, after 2 years, they are been promoted and they are heading the branches. They are not much experience of the lending and other schemes. And same time, public sector bank has to fulfill the conditions of the governments also, government schemes. For that also, they have a pressure. One more thing which government should stop for public sector. Public sector banks, they are selling the third party products. Banks should stick to the banking only. They should not sell this insurance, mutual fund business. So, their concern will be because higher ups, they are getting the incentive.
But selling these insurances or the mutual funds, somehow they put more pressure to the staff?
Yes, because higher ups, they are getting the incentive. They are having the incentive, they are having the parties, they are having the foreign tours. For that, higher ups, they will pressurize the people, you go for this, you have a target. When see one person sitting in the branch with two or three staff, they cannot do all these
things.
All
the things, all the things, exactly.
They have so many parameters, you have to lend the retail, you have lend the government schemes, you have to sell this third party products.
Third party products, okay.
So, means he don't have time to even the recovery of the follow up for the whatever he has lended.
Okay, okay. Actually, but what are the way ahead to somehow change the working culture or let's say ki jo problem abhi bhi hai lekin usse aage kaise jaye? Because this image is there ki now that you cannot get the what you call the customer friendly response from the public sector banks. वहाँ से ये दिक्कत आएगी या तो वो मना कर देंगे या फिर वो हो सकता है कि कल को what is the way forward?
They have to specifically introduce branches. Some branches for retail lending.
Okay.
They should be having some sufficient staff and sufficient knowledge, sufficient experience for that retail lending. For public government schemes, there should be some branches restricted. In all branches, if you will find that all work will be done, that for that you have to more staff.
Okay.
Without sufficient staff, you cannot go for.
So are you saying that the public sector banks are understaffed?
Yes, it is there. See, since last 10-20 years, business has grown such a long, but staff is still there. Whatever people are retiring, in their place, fresh recruitment is not sufficient.
That
is the crisis for the banks. There are so many things. They have to give the loan. They have to follow up. They have to make the recovery. So many things they have to run. But by another appeal to the government, if they want banking should be done banking, they should stop all this nonsense third party selling in public sector banks.
Okay, but if you are saying that this is the kind of a nonsense, I mean, this is the, normally the thing, the pressure comes to the bank officials, but the private sector banks are also doing it.
For that, they have a separate cells, separate staffs. Mm-hmm. They are doing business. See, one private insurance company, he is have a tie-up with the one public sector bank. If public sector bank has a 2,000 branches with 10,000 or 20,000 staff, that private company, they are having an outlet of 2,000, they are using banks to 2,000 outlets and 20,000 staff and whatever, what the bank is getting, it is not more than 1% of the total income of the bank.
Total income of that service.
Not service.
Okay.
Total whatever bank is getting this profit, out of that only maximum 1% he is getting from that third party product. So for that they are pushing all their staff for this third party selling.
Okay. Professor Aman Agarwal has joined me. Professor Aman Agarwal is the director of the Indian Institute of Finance. Very warm welcome on the show, Professor Agarwal. Finance Minister Nirmala Sitaraman has come up with ideas of for the public sector banks to somehow, I mean, bank staff should be more savvy to and smart to woo more customers. And in fact, she has gone further to ask bank officials to dedicate a branch level and personally connect with the customers to provide better services. What is your take on? I mean, this seems very, very, very good idea, but how practically feasible this seems to you?
No, I think it is a very practical solution. I'm very happy that the finance minister, Ms. Nirmala Sitaraman, has taken this stand. I've been very vocal on this for the last 2 years now, that actually the credit offtake, which is not taking place despite the RBI easing of liquidity, reducing the rates, and they're not transferring it, is not only not because of the decisions being taken at the board level, but more because of the fact that the branch level operations are not smooth enough, and the customers, whether it is MSMEs, it is individuals, small homeowners, or anyone else who wants to take a loan or facilitate or do functionality, or most of them are becoming hindrances for this further to go forward. And that is why we are not seeing the credit offtake take place. No one says that you do not do the due diligence. You do not do the paperwork. You do not check whether the credibility is there. But the question is whether the loan can be given. And I know many cases in the last 5-6 months where there have been MSME customers who have been creditable, have been doing business with banks, and they were unable to take loans in the last 6-7 months on one pretext or the other by the branch managers responsible at various public sector banks. And this was something which was happening, and you know, they were always taking the case of the fact that they are scared of something happening wrong. Now, where customers have been paying off their loans year after years, for years after decades, on one side, the bank manager would say he's a very good customer. On the other side, you are not giving easy credit, not giving loans. And this is something which is a dichotomy, and this cannot be handled at the board level. It cannot be handled at the chairman level. It was supposed to be at the grassroots level. And I'm very happy that the finance minister come forward and said that this is something which needs to be taken care of, smoothened, so that the liquidity can actually go into the hands of the people who want to invest, who want to grow India, who want, whether it is a question of entrepreneurship, whether it's a question of taking loans for houses, whether it's a question of taking loans for cars, or it's a question of taking loans for small businesses or working capital loan or capital loans which are there for long-term purposes.
Okay, these problems are there. These problems, what you talk... Proactive. Okay. Professor Agarwal, these problems are there, we understand that. But as for that, what have been the general impression about the public sector bank officials, about they have been lazy, they have been non-cooperative to the customers, but the impression, and the, normally they say that they are overworked, understaffed, and probably things are being put to them. I mean, there is a more pressure to function. So how to somehow find a better way, or let's say the middle way?
No, I appreciate this concern which is raised by a large number of banking associations and staff associations of banks, where they say they understaff. But you see, please understand the thing. The business has also gone down in the last couple of years. It's not that the same amount of magnitude of business is there. And what was happening, in fact, the Moody's report, which came out in November, December, clearly outlined the fact that the bankers at the lower level and even at the senior level have given away a huge amount of funds in the way back in 2008 to 2012, which has led to this NPA crisis. Now, if they could give out loans at that time, what is stopping them from giving out loans even today? Now, it is not that business has gone up 10 times or 50 times, that the amount of load work which is there in terms of giving, granting loans or facilitating banking activities has gone down. Secondly, the number of banks which are in operation today, whether it is a question of payments bank, whether it's a question of small micro segment banks, whether it's a question of other digital payments functions which have come in, have enhanced magnitudinally, and which was not there 10, 15 years back. So I do not see the reason for that load going up. Yes, in last 1.5, 2 years, what has happened is that the Urjit Patel, the previous governor of Reserve Bank of India, had put about 13 to 14 banks under PCA, which meant they could not hire, they could not open up new branches, they could not do activities, they could not give further loans, which Mr. Shaktikant Das, when he took over as the governor, has been trying to resolve the issue, and very few banks now are in PCA. And this situation will help resolve the problem of the staffing which is required or the branching which is required as of today. But given the fact the large amount of people are actually doing transactions digitally, that has actually reduced the workload, because at every day before, one had to go and do an NEFT, one had to go and make a demand draft. Today, people don't make demand drafts. People transfer NEFT sitting at their home, sitting in their mobiles. So given those conveniences, which was consuming a huge chunk of time of a bank branding manager or a clerk working there. So they should look at doing other activities now, expanding the markets, and specifically when the government is trying to put forward and say the markets need liquidity. The industrialists are saying the market needs liquidity. They've been wanting to have it. The MSME segment is saying they want liquidity. Then when framework is giving it, the politicians, the cabinet is providing for the funds, then why is the banks not doing it at all when they have the systems in place? I think this risk-averse behavior or this work-shirking behavior is not at all appropriately acceptable for the fact that you do not have employees. I think the business needs to go on. But one more thing.
At least a couple of years ago, in fact, 2 years ago, when this NPA crisis was looming large nationwide, in fact, it took somehow the political colors as well. The public sector banks were under tremendous pressure from the government of India, from the various political parties, that they normally obliged to the the big industries and the politically connected people to give the large loans, and somehow it turned to the NPA. But now, as the reports are coming that the public sector banks are recovering the NPAs, and this has gone down. In fact, more than 2 lakh crore have been recovered since last 9 months. But yes. Ms. Nirmala Sitaraman is saying that public sector banks should not blindly rely on the rating agency data. They should also somehow put their personal touch to disburse the loan. How it can be feasible, or how practical it would be?
I'm very happy you asked this, because we were the founders of the Money Laundering Act. It was the Parliament of India consulted us way back in 94-95 and then created the Money Laundering Act. Okay. After which the KYC norms were based on our work, where IMF and World Bank took decisions way back in 2004 to introduce KYC norms. The whole objective of KYC was know your customer. It was not a paperwork, not getting Aadhaar, not getting PAN card, not getting address proof, and then the KYC is done. The prime objective, if you look at the work which was published in Finance India way back in 2003, December 2003 or March 2004 issue, clearly outlines the fact that the bank managers, as they used to know the customers before, they knew the business of the customers very well, they must do. It's rating agencies can only do one work, but their own paraphernalia, their own structure should know about who is doing what. The bank manager has the facility. The banks are providing them facilities. I remember of someone who took a loan recently, a home loan, where the loan was processed very smoothly by the SBI executives, the home loan division in Noida. And the people were working very hard for it, and they would go to the customer. They will check on the customer. They will get information. They will know about the whereabouts. Now, when it can be done by a few segments of the same bank and bank officials, why can't it be done by most of the other people? I think it's a question of a mental aptitude change The reason has been that earlier, bank manager was a custodian of large number of authoritative rules because of every small activity being handled by the bank. Today, you want a passbook to be updated, you go to a machine. You want transactions to take place, you go to a machine. So large part of their powers have been curtailed to a great extent where they do not have. Now they only exercise power where they see is not benefiting them. And this is where I think Nirmala Sitaramanji has been talking about reducing administrative measures, trying to introduce transparency in the system, trying to introduce ease of doing business. We have been going up in the ranking. But if you even look at those ranks, one of the components where we are not going up is the way the business can grow in this country because of the bank finances which are taking place. And banks are the backbones of any economy today. The finance, the way finance moves from one hand to the other, the banks are facilitating that. The banks have done a tremendous job in this country. There is no question of questioning that dirt. Okay, but I think it is a question of moving forward and facilitating the activities.
Stay with us, Professor Agarwal. I come to you about especially, I mean, if she is saying and somehow encouraging the public sector banks to go forward, what are the protection normally, has the government of India has taken the protection about the political pressure that it was used to say that normally the politicians pressurize the public sector bank. But what about this? The general impression is coming, especially when we are doing a show, a couple of the messages also come. This is only the mindset of the officials of the public sector bank that somehow hinders the process, that how somehow stops them to become more customer friendly. And that is the main thing. Yahi ek karan hai jiski wajah se nahi hota hai.
Any, that is not the reason.
Okay.
Because you had talked about the NPAs.
Mm-hmm.
Earlier, because of the NPAs, there was a lot of cases, pressure of the branch managers and bank officials. Because of the outside pressure, they have given the disbursement of the loans.
Now, outside pressure, but the political pressure.
Yes, earlier it was there. For that, they have been punished. Means they have been. Now, if you will pressurize the banks, leave on the bank's decision. You go, you go further, but you do the all formalities. Okay. You know your customer. Mr. Aman Agarwal is telling, he is right. We have to see. But for that, we have the time and people to go and know the customer.
Okay.
That's why we are concerned for this staff. And for that, see, for housing loan, you should have some specialized branches. For specialized branches with sufficient staffs, because if number of cases will come you will not be able to disperse, again it will be a bad image of the bank. So you have to provide sufficient staff also.
Okay.
Means you are opening a housing finance division and you don't have the staff, then machines will not do the job. Na.
Okay.
Machine can disperse the cash, they can accept the cash. But this advances, loans, lending, it is to be done by the people and trained people, those having the...
But on the one hand, when there is a demand and there is a kind of indication from the government of India that somehow the government is going forward to merge the banks, don't you think it will somehow create more pressure to the people of, officials and the bank
officially,
but because eventually they will lay off a couple of the employees. So, this is the fight that you have been,
Yes, it was the fight of the trade unions that after the mergers, number of branches will be closed.
Okay.
They will be shifted, staff will be shifted, because when branch will be closed, that staff will be shifted somewhere else. In one branch, where three banks are there on the same road and it is merged with one bank, there will be pressure on one branch.
Okay.
Because all three banks branches, customer will come to one branch. Na?
That's right.
How they will handle all this? For that, they have to see that all the branches should not be closed.
Okay.
So many things, micro level also, they have to see.
Okay. On this note, the micro level, I mean, he has made a very important point. Professor Agarwal, very short comment from you. I mean, the general public normally has been very harsh to the officials of the public sector bank. We call them little lazy, non-customer friendly. But you talked about the NPAs. In fact, a couple of months ago, the government of India, in fact, the finance minister said that the public sector banks officials should go forward and release the loan because there was a sense of panic among the public sector banks to release the loan.
Now, you see, two things which I would like to clarify here. First of all, as I said, the productivity is very high. They're profitable. They're very hardworking people. There is no doubt about it. And that's where we are seeing banking in India grow very well as against the rest of the world. So for the important thing which I have seen when I was there, the World Bank in Washington, D.C. about 20 years back, I saw the merger of Chase and Manhattan Bank. Here I saw Centurion and Bank of Punjab being merged. And recently we saw the subsidiaries of SBI being merged with SBI. Now, this fear that the branches will go off, please understand, yes, there will be some branches which may go off, but then business will grow. These people are not being thrown out of the bank. Okay. There's a reallocation of work which is taking place. Okay. So it's the same job, suppose there are two branches in the same locality, there are two branch managers, maybe they are reallocated, but the staff will be more now. So one bank which is there, there'll be more staff to look at and the branch becomes bigger. So it is not that the staff is being thrown out there is a lack of staff which is going on anymore because of mergers. Even when we saw Chase Manhattan in the US, even there it was not the case. So it is not, in fact, there is a surplus staff which most banks and financial institutions have because when it comes to regulation, when it comes to digital, there will be one digital department. Earlier there were five digital departments.
I think Mr. Ashwini Dada is not agreeing that there is a surplus of the staff. Okay.
We should not compare Indian public sector bank with US. Because there is a condition of the
different culture, different things. Okay. On this note, I mean, the time is not allowing me to go forward. Thank you very much, Professor Aman Agarwal, for joining me. Thank you very much, Mr. Ashwini Rana, for coming and talking to us in the studio. So, in a bit to revive this image of the public sector banks, Finance Minister has asked a couple of the steps of the officials of these banks to be more savvy and smart, to woo more customer and retain the customer, and also dedicated branch level staff to personally connect with the customer to provide better services. That's all we have in this edition of Public Forum. Thank you very much for watching.